ambulance service. Is the patient breathing?
It's rush hour in winter, and a distressed woman in South Yorkshire is calling 999.
Did he hit by a car? Yeah. Was he on a motorbike?
Yeah, he was on a bike.
In the crew room at the Nostell Air Base, the team are listening in to what sounds like a hit and run.
Tell him
to keep nice and still. I don't know the extent of his injuries
at the moment. Okay.
You said there was a lot of blood, so it's...
Send you. Dispatcher Tyrone is scrambling HeliMed 99.
This is a motorbike V-car, is it?
I think so, yeah.
I weren't sure if it was pedestrian. All right.
Details are sketchy, but there's no time to lose.
Good left.
Dr. Tim and paramedics Pete and Lisa are taking off for Doncaster. Flight time is 5.5 minutes.
Air Desk 98, do we know what resources and ETAs on this detail?
You've got Tech Joker just pulled up. This kid's got a broken leg. He sounds really irritable on the phone and agitated, and he's got a serious leg fracture.
Tim, good, he wasn't wearing a helmet.
He was agitated, combative, he wasn't wearing a helmet, so I'm already mentally thinking, oh, this could be very bad news. He could have a serious head injury.
Got some blues.
Right.
You see where my trying to tell them there.
It's quite built up.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? I'm looking at these big car parks down here.
HeliMed 99 is over a busy lakeside sports and leisure complex. It's going to be a difficult place to land.
So you're right over at water now, Jeff?
I know, yeah, I'm going to put it over the other side over there. Just check that tree behind us, please.
Pilot Jeff is descending in darkness. He needs the eyes of the whole team and the help of night vision goggles.
There should be a tree behind
beside
us.
Quite close to this tree.
That's all right. It's not
still a little tiny tree, but
it's not as high as, is it?
It's a long way away. Quite sloping, this and all, Jeff.
Towards me.
Yeah, it's very high up right on side.
Oh, yeah.
I'll jump out in case anyone comes up.
Yeah.
I'll clear out, yeah?
Yes.
They're safely down.
Is it down here and right?
It's up near the road, yeah.
Pete and Dr. Tim have a short walk to their patient, who's at the side of a fast and busy road.
We find a little crossing, don't we? Yeah, when this next car's gone, we'll make his way over.
He's in the care of local paramedics. The driver of the car which hit him did stop.
What's he like?
He's not responded at all to us. Quite a bad head injury.
Hello.
Hi.
How are we doing?
What sort of state's he in?
Right, I've only just arrived myself, and this is Andrew. Andrew's been going across the road by car doing 35 to 40 miles an hour.
Okay, so he's got an airway?
He has at the moment.
30-year-old Andrew Stewart was crossing the busy road when he was hit by the car, which threw him into the air. He has deteriorated rapidly in the minutes since the 999 call.
Feels all right, belly's soft. Have you listened to his chest, my friend?
I've literally just got himself.
Do you want to have a quick listen?
Yeah.
Look at his pelvis. Looks okay.
Andrew was on his way home from his job in retail when the accident happened. He lives close by.
Where's this leg injury then?
Left leg seems abnormal.
So his GCS is a bit disappointing. What's pupils doing? Andrew, stick your tongue out for me.
Andrew is now dangerously unresponsive. Without swift medical intervention, Dr. Tim knows he may die. He wants to get him straight to hospital.
How far from Donny is he to drive?
About 5-7 minutes.
Yeah.
The nearest hospital is in Doncaster, but it's already stretched to the limit.
Is he manageable for us?
I think he needs tubing in the near future.
Okay,
so it's just whether we do it here in the middle of nowhere and freezing cold, or if we take him to Donny, which is a bit easier. So he's bleeding quite a lot from that head injury, isn't he? Okay, let's get IV access, prepping for RSI. Get him tubed here, then.
The team can't wait. To save Andrew's life, they must anaesthetise him in a procedure called an RSI. And they'll have to do it at the side of the busy road. They need more room than the cramped ambulance affords.
Tim, you happy here, facing back at DCS? Head up. So head, feet. So I'm setting a kit dump up. If we can get IV access, make sure we've got some ECG monitoring on. Suction out and ready with the yanker attached, please.
We've got this pedestrian that's been knocked over and he's received a significant head injury. It appears to be isolated at this moment in time. So in order to protect his airway and any potential brain injury that might have occurred, Tim's just going to carry out a procedure called RSI to pop him to sleep and take control of his breathing. That way we can monitor the parameters much better than we would be able to manually sort of managing his airway.
You all right here?
Just a touch further, please.
Is he definitely flushed, yeah?
Yeah, flushed well.
Fantastic. Can you get me a litre of saline on a giving set, yeah? Thank you.
Andrew, keep nice and still.
Got battle signs under eyes, haven't they now, Tim, as well?
They're placing Andrew into a medically induced coma, a procedure usually carried out in a hospital.
Right, can you attach that to his drip, please? Is that in?
Yes.
So long blade, Fuji, A-tube.
Dr. Tim can now see the full extent of Andrew's head wound, and it's dangerously deep.
So he's actually got an arterial spurter there?
Yeah. Yeah.
Never rains, but pause. Right, can you, is there a spare paramedic? Can you get me a bit of Celox? Just cut a little square of Celox. Or just bring some out. Right, are we all ready to go?
Doing an anaesthetic by the roadside is a high pressure moment. The stakes are high. If you get it right, you've given your patient the best possible care and chance of good recovery. But unfortunately, if you get it wrong, there is potential to actually kill the patient.
Right, so, fentanyl, ketamine,
SATs are 100% still.
Covered in blood here.
Did you just pop that dressing over?
Yeah.
The team are sedating Andrew. Once the drugs kick in, they will take over his breathing.
That's a minute.
Okay, let's have a look.
By the light of a head torch, Dr. Tim must access Andrew's windpipe.
Okay, I've got pretty good view. Tube, please.
He's passing a breathing tube directly into Andrew's lungs.
Thank you very much. Hold it nice and tight.
There's no room for error.
Okay, Fuji out, please. Cuff up, please. Right, who's the star with the stethoscope?
They've done it. Andrew is successfully anaesthetized, and the team can pump air into his lungs.
Super job. Yeah. Right, Pete, can you help me secure the tube, please? Lisa, can you please press blood pressure so I get blood pressure? It's a really firm pressure, buddy, that's good.
128.85.
Oh, what a cool RSI. It wasn't too bad in the end, actually, Pete.
No, I thought that, but I had every confidence in you, Tim, to be fair.
Thanks, Pete.
So we're going to go by road to Northern General. We're only a stone's throw from Doncaster, but it's not a major trauma centre because of the extent of his injuries. He needs to be at a major trauma centre. So the plan is to go by road.
Andrew isn't out of the woods yet.
Right, up we go.
Okay.
The race is on to get into Sheffield's Northern General Hospital, 20 miles away.
So we'll keep an eye on his pupils, Pete, maybe give him some hypertonic if he starts looking a bit dodgy.
His condition is critical. Going by road will give the team more room to work on Andrew.
Hiya, it's Yorkshire Air Ambulance here, one of the paramedics. Can I put an at-mist in for a trauma patient that's coming by road and the aircraft will be following on behind empty to pick up the crew?
It's almost 30 minutes by road, but Andrew's head wound can't wait. This life or death journey will require all of Dr. Tim's skill.
So he's actually got an arterial spurter there?
Yeah.
30-year-old Andrew Stewart was lucky to survive. He was in a coma for 3 weeks after suffering a brain injury when he was hit by a car on his way home from work.
I can't remember anything of the day of the accident when I woke up. That's the last time I remember anything.
CT scans found Andrew had bleeding on the brain and a fractured skull, as well as a severely broken left leg, which surgeons fixed with bolts and screws. He spent 5 weeks in hospital before returning home to face a long recovery.
I used to love fitness. I can't do that anymore. I can't run or anything like that. But in general, day to day is fine. You know, I can get on my day to day life. I can walk on it, just get tired every now and then.
No charges were brought against the car driver. Today, Andrew remains grateful to the air ambulance team who saved his life.